Hurry, Lord. Where the heck did you come from? So short.
Seems to be in the shed, so if you don't mind.
I was just having a good time with Rosie and suddenly Gordon comes up after me, and then suddenly I'm the bad one. Just because I'm Gordon does any other English.
Didn't expect to see you back so soon.
So, did you enjoy your day out?
No, I didn't.
Oh, why is that?
It's because of, Jordan.
Oh, Gordon, you know better than to listen to him. You should have bumped him.
Now that you mention it, I should have done that.
But don't worry, James.
Whoa! Oh, holy Lord! Where the heck did you come from, Henry?
The shed.
Oh, gracious! Why are you even here?
I just go back from playing a smelly good string.
Ugh, don't tell me about it. Stupid good strings.
Hey, good strings may be smelly, but that doesn't mean they're bad.
Yeah, I know.
If you want Gordon to shut up, maybe you should tell him to shut up.
Okay. Gosh. You are sure to get rid of us. Okay. James took off like a rocket. Sorry, Rosie, can't talk right now. Hello, Jordan.
James.
What is it?
Shouldn't you be fetching my coaches on that bed?
Yeah. Well, shut up!
Don't you tell me to shut up. It was your fault. You were supposed to be in the shed.
But it's not my fault. You were the one who interrupted my talk with Rosie.
Who cares about your talk with Rosie? I care about pulling the express.
Oh, yeah? Really?
Yes. So, just fix my coaches, you shrimp.
Hey, well, I may be vain, but I'm lots of fun.
Oh, shut up.
Well, what if a bee stung you on the nose? Then your nose would look like this.
I'm such a stupid dumb James.
Well, who cares? You're smiling like an idiot.
It's not my fault, though.
I'll just go.
I want you back here by 11.
Don't tell me what to do, you stupid, idiotic Gordon. Gordon is always picking on me. This is just no fair. How is he looking if he gets in trouble all the time?
You want me to prove that I like to smile like an idiot? Well, I'll prove that I don't smile like an idiot. By going into Thomas's shed. See, I'll prove it.
And Gordon was racing along the tracks.
James called me an idiotic person.
Die!
There's no way I'm too large. And James always says that. I don't need to sleep in tennis sheds all the time. Now move along, James.
Dirty objects. James rolled into Toby's shed. At least I'm little enough to sleep here. Good might be too large.
Hi there, James. What are you doing here?
Nothing. This place is actually kind of cozy, if you ask me.
I know! We've been keeping you dreaming all the time. So, is this why you're sleeping here? Because you don't want to sleep with your mistakes anymore? Because that place is quite a dump.
Yes.
Should probably make your shed bigger.
Oh, who is that big bossy boy rolling in?
I'll prove you wrong, James.
Gordon started to keep on moving. Gordon kept on rolling in and rolling out. And James and Percy kept on laughing at him.
Gordon can't fit in the shed. He stinks just like a skunk. You made me fall, you little punk.
It's not funny! Gracious! Goodness gracious, I can only fit my tender and a half of my boiler in here. Oh my gosh!
Only an extravagant one. They will attack us, his sleeping sheep, not big bossy answers.
Down, down! Oh my gosh, ugh. Why is Toby's shed always so little? I can only fit my tender and half of my boiler. This is ridiculous.
Gordon kept on trying to fit in, but there was no use. If he could sleep in, he'd have to let half his tender out of the way. But if he moved front, he could only fit his tender and half of his boiler.
Oh, the indignity,
said Gordon, and he chuffed away, with the other engines laughing at him. But then Gordon will try to come back. But that's a story for another day.